Francis Kipling Stevens. I don't think you know what you got yourself into. You can't just throw yourself in the ring and throw out challenges like that, okay? You're dealing with the Order of the Black and me, and you've dealt with me before. You know what, Francis? This time, it's a little bit more serious, pal. You made a challenge for the Psycho Circus. I don't think you understand what the Psycho Circus is, but we do, especially me. I won the 2007 Psycho Circus, so I know what it's like to last in there. And I don't think you got what it takes to even last 5 minutes with one of these guys. I don't even think you last 5 seconds. So before you go throwing out challenges, why don't you think about it a little bit? Because this one's going to end your career.
Whipwreck, you and I have been doing this for over 10 years now. And now you've got Scyther behind you. Well, guess what? I got the man here, Stockade. And what he has in plan for you two, well, I'll let him tell you all about it. Tell him, big man.
Kip, you don't understand, do you? You don't understand what you put yourself in the middle of. And then you recruit Reckless and Wasted? They don't understand either. You think Mikey and Scyther are going to be your saviors? That they're going to help you? Mikey? He's a shell of his former self. And Scyther doesn't know his left from right. Scyther's been decimated by me more times than I can count. And Mikey Whipwreck has fallen to the superstar more times than anyone else. So Kip, you can make all the challenges, you can make all the threats. But threats fall on deaf ears. Because you can't stop what you see before you. At the Psycho Circus, Whipwreck, the match you created will be the match that causes your downfall. Because I don't care just about beating you. The Order doesn't care just about beating you. I want to tear you limb from limb, and I want to send you back home to your children in a wheelchair. At the Psycho Circus. At the circus, Mikey. Kip, Scyther, Reckless and Wasted. It all ends. And everything is gonna fade to black.
Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to episode 5 of NYWC Connected. I am your host, the newly clean-shaven NYWC champion, Alex Reynolds. And as you've seen, the Psycho Circus main event has been set. On one side, you have the Order of the Black and Dickie and Ricky against Freaks and Geeks, Mikey Whipwreck, Scyther, Francis Kipling Stevens, and Reckless and Wasted. Now, before the Psycho Circus event, we have Miracle on 112, which is this Saturday in Port Jefferson, New York. And obviously in the main event, it is yours truly, Alex Reynolds, defending his NYWC championship against big-time Tony Burma. Now, let me touch on that real quick. Now, I'm no, mathematician, but I've been in the NYWC for about three and a half years, and I've won every single singles title there is to win here. Tony Burma, on the other hand, has been in the NYWC for 8 years. How many singles titles has he won? Zero. Now, if this were a tag match, hey, maybe it would be a different story. But Tony Burma, it's a singles match. And statistically, the way it looks like Alex Reynolds is going to be walking out of Port Jefferson Station still NYWC champion.
My name is Pat Buck, and I've been pulled away from my training class here at the NYWC Dojo to address what I think about Dr. Tom Pritchard and his rare appearance at NYWC this Saturday night in Port Jefferson. Well, you see, if you don't know who Dr. Tom is, you're an idiot. He's the head trainer of WWE and is in charge of the guys there at Florida Championship Wrestling. You see, on this Saturday, a lot of the guys are looking forward to Dr. Tom. But for myself, Tom, from trainer to trainer, I'm not going to let you know what I feel. Just have to buy a ticket and see what I think about Dr. Tom coming to the NYWC this Saturday night in Port Jefferson.
Nach.
best month at NYWC Tour de Circus, other than Alex Reynolds stealing the show, there was one other match that really, really captivated the fans' attentions. That was a three-way match between Quiet Storm, Bruno Marciano, and the premier athlete, Tony Nese. It was a phenomenal match. Here are some clips. It seems that ever since I beat Tony Nese for the NYWC Championship, it's been a little sour. I mean, I tried to get him on the show to interview him, you know, get his thoughts after the match. And he said, like he said out there, he got paid for 15 minutes of work. He's not doing any overtime. Which, hey, you know what? I respect. Each his own. But, Tony Nese, this Saturday in Port Jeff, Miracle on 112, you're in another three-way with Bruno Marciano and Papadon. And you know what? I'm sure it's going to be another classic match.
Oh! Look what it is. A camera backstage at a wrestling event at the NYWC Academy. Who would have thought, right? No, but seriously, for a minute. It's cold outside. I got my jacket on. I'm going to try to stay warm. This Saturday, NYWC presents Miracle on 112. And on that spectacular show, we're gonna have a three-way dance. Bruno Marciano, the Greek god Papadon, and Maverick Anthony Nese, a man that I despise with all my soul. See, now he's going by the name the premier athlete. The golden boy now has a beard and a dark side. Well, you can have whatever you want, Anthony. Bottom line is this, three-way dance. Bruno, you're a great wrestler. You ain't me. Anthony, told you a year ago, they didn't see it. I saw it. And now, everyone else is seeing it. You're a prick. But come Saturday, they're gonna see a match for the ages. So it is written, let it be told. Your Greek god has spoken.
Ladies and gentlemen, I have a very special segment on this episode of Connected, a live interview with BTR, Ryan Rush, and Tony Burma, the guy I'm going to beat this Saturday.
We'll see about that.
Folks, let's keep it professional.
Things
just
got weird.
You just got
big man
now, huh? So, BTR, singles matches this weekend, huh?
You know it, man.
Ryan.
Yeah.
Manny Martinez, what are your thoughts?
It happens to be Manny Martinez's birthday this Saturday. And I kind of feel a little bad because going up against one half of BTR means more than likely he's going to spend a portion of his special day knocked out cold.
Well, we want to wish an early birthday to Manny Martinez.
Happy birthday, Manny.
Now, Ryan.
Yeah?
What are your thoughts on being the only member of BTR that could possibly have a victory this Saturday in Port Jefferson?
Well, I don't see it going down like that. Cute, though. Cute.
Real cute. It's an interview for two people, man. Why don't you start asking me some questions about how I'm going to take your title?
Oh, all right. So, Ryan, how does it feel to have a partner who's never won a singles title in the 8 years that he's been here because he's a loser?
Boom! How does that feel, huh? How does that feel? Oh, man. And a question you should be asking yourself on December 11th is how you're going to feel without this. Because miracles do happen in Port Jefferson on 112, baby. BTR. See you there.
Put some ice on that.
Did I really deserve that? Honestly, I was being a pacifist, like Gandhi. Trying to be a good reporter, asking questions. Questions that people wanted to know. What did Tony Burma do? Fire me in the face for no apparent reason. But you know what? That's okay, I'm gonna be the bigger man, I'm gonna be the professional. Now, Miracle on 112 this Saturday, besides me beating Tony Burma and retaining my NYWC title, John Silver is gonna defend his NYWC Fusion title against Chris Forza. Mikey and Scyther are defending their NYWC tag team titles against the uninvited All Money's Legal. Don't forget that big triple threat match with Tony Nese, Bruno Marciano, and Papadon. Now, ladies and gentlemen, if you go to nywcwrestling.com, you can order tickets early, and they're only $10, which I know is probably a lot for you, but it's a discount. So, nywcwrestling.com for all your NYWC info. Ladies and gentlemen, just been connected.